quiz online. Hello, hi guys. Happy weekend. Compliments of the season, because Christmas is smelling everywhere. Who is here? Please come up, let's chat. I'm waiting for you guys. I'm going to be talking about this new updates, like Kilo Day, this new YouTube update. If you are here, please say hi. Cosmo, close that door if you don't want me to be upset with you. If you are here, please say hi. Hi. So let's have a chat about this new YouTube family update that is like, I can't believe that the rule, like, I don't can't believe that the update is here, like, is here to stay. I can't believe it. So please, if you are here, say hi. Let's have a chat for a while, just a couple of minutes, and we are good. Say hi if you are here, guys. Say hi. Happy weekend to you guys. Happy weekend. Cosmo, sit down, okay? Happy weekend. Hi, Shizzy. Ne, Kewan. Kedo, Timen. How are you doing? Hi there. How are you doing? Don't be small. I want to talk about you guys thought about this new YouTube update. Is just what's happening for you've not read your because this I believe they sent email to everyone about I have my email here. This children COPPA, I think, yeah, it's COPPA law about putting kids in America is under 13 years. It's not only kids channel, it didn't affect only kids channel. Like if you are doing family vlog and sometimes you put your kids in front of the camera, maybe you are cooking and you want your kids to cook with you, or just like for instance, hi dear, hi. Like for instance, Christina, stop screaming. I'm cooking and I want Christina or Cosmo to come and cook with me, and the child do the cooking. As long as the child is there, it also affects you, because they will ask you under your video, they will ask you if that is for kids. If you are targeting kids' audience, that means it will affect you too. So that particular video, it will affect that particular video. So it's not just family channels are involved, or maybe you're making a child's hair, like a baby. Maybe if I'm making Christina's hair and then I post the video, that hair is a like baby's children kids hairstyle, so it will definitely, you have to set that it's for kids, because they ask if the child is a model, means if I'm making her hair, she's the model, or maybe if I'm dressing her up, she's the model. So it affects not only kids family, it also affects family channel in total, where the kids always come on board on the video, in the video. So it's just I can't believe it's happening. Like, I can't believe this is happening. Hi Mary, hi Getano, hi, happy weekend. I can't really believe. So I'm just asking for the, like, I can't believe it. For my own channel, I've fixed down, like, I've put a lot of videos where maybe it's just Cosimo, or where I just put in the pack for them, like mostly videos that I know that is targeted for kids, I put them on private. If I didn't want to delete them, because it's kind of memory, so I just private the videos. So, because if you keep making videos where the kids are in, definitely YouTube are never going to be recommend, they will never recommend that video. Like the video will never be promoted by YouTube if people find it interesting, and the monetization is going to be almost gone. Like there will be, but it's just something that you don't want to, you won't like, you know. So I just feel sorry for the family vlog channel where the kids are the real actor. And I believe that for me, this YouTuber have helped a lot of kids to like discover their talents. So I don't know what is happening. This is really going to discourage parents. I only understand that they asked to specify if it's channeled for kids. Something like that. But when you read down, when you read for the question, there is a place they ask the question that people will ask them. I don't know how, but if you read down to the, there is another link you will click, like for example, video that is this, as long as the child model inside and the other. It's not all the videos that the child is in, okay? It's not all the videos. There's some videos that the child will be in into the vlog, but you're not getting kids inside the channel. Like if you are reviewing toys, like if it's a video where you are doing toys review, is completely not it's not good at all. So there's a lot of things. Hi Janet, thank you for joining me, Janet. Thank you so much, sis. Thank you. It's something I'm feeling really sorry for a lot of families that this is going to affect, because a lot of families are going to be affected by this. Like, you know, those big YouTubers, those big kids channel that make fun, like do something fun that the other kids like. I'm just feeling sorry for them. I'm just like, what? Because for me, YouTube have grown a lot of kids. Like, they discover their talent. They can be in commercial, like they do commercial and other stuff they do. So this update is, I'm really really sad for a lot of kids channel that this is going to affect. I hope in the future they're going to find it, but because you can't just take someone's business down like that. A lot of families make ends living from this their kids channel. It's just not easy. Yeah, I'm gonna check. Yeah, check, because Cosimo, can you go out of that place? Can you just go out of that place, or you want me to be angry right now? My God, these kids won't let me. So, with that being said, I am talking about my Christmas giveaway as well. What are you guys going to give me for this Christmas? Anyway, so if you are, I don't know, I advise everybody to go read most of the stuff, the email, especially the email sent out by YouTube, and go to YouTube creators channel to listen to what they have to say, because they also have a fine. Like if you disobey this law, you have about, I think, $45,000 to fine to pay if you disobey this this law. So it's something that is nobody is happy. Like nobody. I'm speechless, you know. I'm really really speechless, guys. I'm so like sad for them. I know mine did not affect me much, but I'm just very sad for those that this hit badly like this. So what are you guys going to give me for Christmas? I'm waiting for my cheesy. I saw your comments on my post. We have to raise alarm, but they have to give us Christmas gifts. The way I'm planning to give out, I want to receive too, you know. The people that give out also receive. So I'm making my Christmas list. Like, yes, Christmas list is on. I'm making my Christmas list of things I want, guys. What are you going to give me for this Christmas? This girl, eh? You see this my daughter, eh? See this my daughter. I don't know if anybody has a daughter like this, though. I don't know at all. I don't know if anyone has a daughter like Christina. You see the way she's screaming. She's just not satisfied with one thing. What do you want? You just want to let them know that you are here. Want to let them know that you are here. And I'm also feeling for those people that teach kids, like that teach English, that teach language, a lot of stuff for kids. I don't know how kids are going, because a lot of people are just, I know a lot of people are going to stop, like, those their videos that is targeted to kids. Like, people that teach kids how to speak English, how to speak this language, how to speak language. I think they need to find a a solution to this, because families learn, like here in Italy, a lot of families go to YouTube with their kids to learn English. So they need to find agreement with those kind of channel that family love, especially when they teach, those channel that teach kids the stuff they want to learn. I think they need to find a way with those family. Cosmo, leave this girl alone. Cosmo won't let me either. Jesus. They need to find a agreement with them, because someone cannot sit down at home in front of computer teaching kids how to learn. At the end of the day, like, they get nothing, like, seriously, nothing. It's something that is because a lot of people will just stop doing that. A lot of people will stop making videos that will impact. I know there is a lot that went out of control. Like a lot of this channel that went out of control trying to use their kids to make money. So it's just not good at all. Not good at all. These kids are not having it with me at all. So I want to say hi to you guys, and my Christmas list is on. For those of you that want to give me Christmas gifts, yes, Tessie also received Christmas gifts. For those of you that wish to give me Christmas gifts, my door is open. my door is open. Like I already placed two things on Instagram that I want to receive this Christmas. So guys, my door is open for Christmas. I've started receiving Christmas gift though. Please prepare my own Christmas gift, okay? And send me my own Christmas gift. I will send to you as well, okay? I will send to you as well, guys. So don't say she only wants to receive. No, I don't want to receive only, because receiving is not good. When you receive, you need to give too. So we are going into the season of love. So you receive and make sure you give out as much as you can, okay? So guys, I'm going to go now, because this life is not going to take long, because this baby girl is not going to let me do anything. So I'm going, as you can hear her voice, I'm going to run now. Probably this video, I'm like, why are you screaming? What is the problem? Why are you screaming? My family, I'm going to go now. She just don't want me to talk. Just watch. Let me talk. Hi, everyone. Hi, Cindy. Thank you. Please don't go now. Oh, I said please don't go now. Okay, I'm here. Let's talk. What do you want us to talk about? I'm just like referring to this YouTube new update, how it's going to affect a lot of families here on YouTube. I'm really sorry for those. Like this girl, she just don't want me to talk. When I talk, she screams her own out. Like, why are you screaming? Guys, Jesus, this girl. So I'm just speaking about these people, how it's going to affect a lot of channel. It's really not, I'm feeling sorry for, you don't have the, when you upload your video, if you like, hi, God's time, God's love. When you upload your, if you don't, normally it's from computer to set this, you need to go use your computer, or even if you're using your phone, you go to setting. When you go to Google Chrome, you go to data, not the old updated YouTube studio data. When you go there, you go to your channel. I think when you go to your channel, that is when you need to click advanced setting there. I don't have my computer here. I will have shown you guys. When you click there, it's up to you to see if your channel is only for kids. There is a setting that asks you, your channel is only for kids. You click if you're targeting your audience are kids. If your audience are not kids throughout your channel, you will you click not for kids. Okay, that means whenever you upload a video that you know that your channel is not for kids, your video will automatically be under Not For Kids. But if you don't do this setting at all, YouTube will do it. YouTube will do it for you. Like, YouTube will help you do the setting for you. But and also, it can do it in a like one by one using your YouTube studio with your phone. Like, you click on each video. Let me open one of my video here to show you guys what I mean. Let me open one of my video here. So this is my channel here. So I'm going to open this my last DIY, which is this one here, guys. So when you open it, you click there is this pencil arrow here. You click on that pencil arrow. This is for those that don't have computer to use, okay? When you click that pencil arrow, it will take you, you will see the sign of setting and that pencil sign and the dollar sign. So when you go to this part, you click the setting part. So this setting part will take you to this page here. So when you scroll down, I put my channel as Not For Kids because I'm not targeting kids audience. Okay, when you go there, I'm talking about those that has that don't have computer, those that is using their phone to do everything. So when you go there, this is what you will do on each video. Like, you will do this to every of your video if you don't set your channel as Not For Kids or For Kids. You will reach here, you will see audience in on your phone. You just read the audience. As you can see here, mine is not made for kids because my channel is not made for kids. So I've already set this with computer. I set mine for Not Made For Kids on the computer. So every video I upload that I know for sure is not for kids audience, it will appear like this. But if I upload the video and the video is targeting kids, I will still change it. There is another arrow here where I can change it. See, I click that arrow, it's come up. Yes, it's made for kids, and no, it's not for kids. So this particular video I uploaded is not for kids, and my channels are not for kids. Your computer, if you don't have a computer, you can use your phone, but you have to do this on each one of your video. You have to do this on each video. So good morning, everyone. You have to do this on each video. So good morning, everyone. Ah, I forgot to say that tomorrow will be Sunday. I'm reading you guys comments from here. I'm reading the comments. Let me, because it's easy for me to read this here. Please, what does the new rule say? It's for kids, Cindy. It's going to affect all kids' channel on YouTube. So you need to set it. Click. You don't have to click on. You don't have to click that. You don't have to go for any 18 years old. You don't do that. They sent out email to everyone. Okay, maybe that. They sent out email to everyone. Okay, maybe you have to check the email. Yeah, you're right. I was taking my time to read it today. Yes, God's time, God's love is really, really okay. Can a family channel be considered as for kids because your functions? The thing is that if, like, God's time, God's love, when I know most times you play with your kids, most time you teach your son how to read inside there, and you want him to respond to you, right? That is what they consider made, one of the things they consider made for kids. As long as there is a child's voice. Hi, Annie. Hi, IJ. Hi. Don't mind Cosmo. Cosmo is looking for my trouble, and I'm going to get to him soon. I'm going to get to you soon. Yeah, lucky you're not in Nigeria. We're not in Nigeria. Cosmo, go away from there. Go away from there. So, and it's not every channel, like, it's not every video that you upload that is made for kids, okay? Kids can be in your videos. Like, channels that create content for kids is what they are targeting to. I need to, yes, go read your email, because YouTube sent email to everyone that is to all the YouTube creators. And if you can, okay, go to subscribe to type YouTube. Let me see if I can get it out on my phone. YouTube Create Studio channel. That place you will get all their notification. This girl won't let me. Amore, are you busy? Mineko, YouTube, I don't know. I'm trying to see if I can. I'm looking for it. I think, yeah, Team YouTube. Is it this one? I'm trying to see if it's this one. Not this one. YouTube Create Studio. Type YouTube Create Studio channel on your on YouTube. Go to. Guys, give me 1 minute, okay? Christina is screaming too much. I'm gonna please stop. Yes, I'm back. This girl, she just keeps screaming and screaming. She just don't want to give me space. So just search for YouTube Create Studio. Like, there is YouTube Create Studio where they talk about every update they have here on YouTube. So with that, you will know all the update that is here. This is the YouTube Create Studio here. Look here. This is their channel. So when you subscribe to that channel, you will see all the YouTube new updates. You will be seeing it on that. Like, this one is the talk about the new updates here. This video here, I watched the video. I got the notification the moment they upload the video. So I watched the video, and inside this video, they will show you how to set it. Because in case go subscribe to their channel, like YouTube Creators channel, go to subscribe there, because inside that video they this video here, the lady showed how to reset your channel, she explained a lot inside that video. So if you are not following them, go to subscribe there, because you will get more insight about YouTube and their update. Anytime they update new laws, you will be getting all the notification you want. So exactly, that's what I want to hear, because the email said that the fact you function your kids is not considered. Yes, the fact you function your kids can be in your video, but as long as your audience are not for kids, it's not considered, it's not a child, it's not for children. But if that video function toys, where you are opening toys for your child, like maybe you buy a toy, or where you're teaching your child, you are trying to tell your child to read something, and all that is considered, because most of the time kids watch this kind of stuff. And I think also when you are in the park with your child, where your child is running around in the park and everything, I don't know, but we just need to avoid it, guys. I don't know. Seems to be a safe side. I think kids should appear less. Exactly, that is what I'm trying to do. Kids appear less on your videos is the best thing to do. And you are right, I think kids should appear less, or even if they do, that shouldn't be the main topic. Yes, you shouldn't make kids your main topic. Yes, you stop making kids your main topic. Just be creating videos for yourself, like just for you. Okay, Tessie, thanks. Sorry, please attend to. No, I've given the girl to the father. It's weekend. I handle her every day. So today the dad has to handle her. The girl is, she's growing, she's getting strong. I will check that. Yeah, Cindy, please do check it out, okay? So that you will not fall into that categories. Because even if you don't set it, YouTube will set it for you. Like they say, if your setting go wrong, like they discover that you are not setting it the right way, you might face some consequences. So IJ, how are you and your family? It is helpful. I will have function, like, yeah, you don't have problem, Cindy, because you hardly function your kids here on your channel, so it's not a problem. Tessie, your voice is coming before the action. Really? I don't know why it's like that. I really don't know why. I don't know why my voice is coming. I don't know. Maybe his network is disturbing. I don't know why. Honestly, I don't know why. Maybe my network is bad. Guys, my little man. Annie, no problem. Go attend to him. Let me explain some of the things here for the people that don't, if you haven't set yours, please go to set yours. It's very, very important, okay? because if you don't, their machine is going to set it, and sometimes they are, most of these, their machine don't set it well. So just use your hand to go through it. If you don't have computer, like I said, you can rewind this video, this live video back, and see how to use your phone to set it. But you have to go through each one of your videos to set it. So what age do you think I should click? When you don't have to click any age, ghost time, I use this to look, pay attention here. This is my last video, okay? So when you click on your video, on each of your video, if you are using your phone, you click that this pencil arrow here. When you click the pencil arrow, it will bring you to this page. You see this page, they have setting dollar sign and another pencil sign here. So when you come to this page, you click this when you come here, okay, click the setting part, which is here. When you click this setting part, I'm talking about those that want to do it one by one with their phone, okay? When you click the setting part, you will go down here. Because I've already set my own channel as not for kids, so any video I upload will come under. You will read it here where it says not for kids, only because my channel is already set not for kids with computer. So, but if any video, if in the future I'm uploading a video that is meant for kids, that's the my son or my daughter is the main topic of that video, I will, even if my computer, my settings said not for kids, I have to come back to reset it. So under here, it said no, it's not for kids, which is the setting on that DIY I uploaded. It's not for kids for sure. So, but if I upload any video in the future that I know is for kids, I will come back to this setting. I will click, there is another arrow beside it here. I will click on that arrow. When I click here, it will take me, wait, I just made it. When I click here on that little arrow, it will bring me back to this part here. You will see, yes, it's for kids. After I'm done uploading that video, it will say, yes, it's for kids. Because that particular content is for kids, I will change the part. Though only that video, only that particular video that is meant for kids, I will change only that one to yes, it's for kids. So you understand me. You don't need to go to any age resisted or anything. If you follow this step, it will bring you. That is only thing they want you to do. You don't have to click age or anything. You just have to follow this step and click. The one that is the content is for kids, you click yes, it's for kids. If it's not for kids, push this particular video I'm using to give an example, it's not for kids. So I'm going to leave it as it is. No, it's not for kids. If you don't understand what I explained here, please let me know so that I will repeat what I said, because I'm not, it's going to be helpful for people. Okay, I get it better. Okay, thank you. I'm happy that you get it better. Yes, I click do not restrict. You don't have to click do not restrict to over 18, meaning all. No, you don't. Cynthia, you need to go for the, what I'm explaining now is what you need to do. You don't need to go for that resisted, what is it called? Let me not cut my tongue. You don't go there at all. Just follow what I explained here to you now. That is what YouTube wants you to do. They don't want you to do that age stuff. They just want you to specify if that particular video, that content is for kids or not for kids. That is the only thing they want you. They don't want you to check age or anything. They just want you to click that part. So guys, in case if you are joining me now, just rewind this video back at the later to watch what I just explained. Please repeat. I'm just joining. Okay, I'm going to repeat it because it's live. So if you go to my any of your channel with you need to go use on your phone, you have a YouTube Studio. Okay, I'm talking to Amaka. Amaka, if you go to YouTube Studio, okay, click on any of your videos. So I'm using my DIY, my last uploaded video, which is my shea butter DIY, to explain this, okay? So this is the face of my DIY here. So when you click on each of your video, you will see pencil arrow on it. When you click on any of it, click that pencil arrow, which is up on your video, on any of your video. So when you click that pencil, it will bring you to this page. I'm talking about Create Studio with your phone. So when you bring you to this page here, you click that, you will see setting, which is this one. The middle one is dollar sign, which is to monetize your videos if your channel is monetized. The other one is another pencil arrow. So all you need to do is to click the setting arrow. So when you click on setting arrow, it will bring you to this page here. So this page here now, because I already set my channel to not for kids, because it's not kids content here, okay? So if I upload any video, it will show no, not for kids. You can't see, I don't know if you can see it well, but if you follow what I'm telling you now, you will see what I'm saying. It will show no, not for kids. Okay, so in the future, if I want to if I'm uploading any video that is for kids, maybe I use my I made a video with my son or my daughter, maybe I'm making the hair for kids, or toy review for kids, or teaching letting him teach language, maybe Italian language here on my channel. I know it's for kids, he's trying to explain to kids, okay? Because my channel is already set not for kids using computer, after uploading that video, I will use this step now that will bring me back here. So because my channel is set no, not for kids, I will click the arrow that is by the side. And when I click the arrow down here, they will give you the two options YouTube always give. One is yes, it made for kids, and the other one is no, it's not made for kids. So because in the future I'm going to upload a video that is made for kids, I will click on that yes, it's made for kids. But if the video is not made for kids and you've not set your channel at all with computer, you will click no, it's not made for kids. The moment you click it, you go up here, you save your video. So you need, if you don't have computer to set your channel at once, you need to do this with your Create Studio app, like on each of your videos that are not made for kids, because if you don't set it yourself, YouTube machine might set it the way you don't like, because it's a machine that they put to set it. Hello Amaka, hi there, hi. So you need to set each and all your videos that are not made for kids, you need to set them one after the other by yourself. So when you set them, YouTube don't have to reset them again. But anyone, any of your content that is made for kids, you need to set it made for kids. The one that are not made for kids, you set it not made for kids. So that is what they ask to do. And if you don't set it, or if you keep making content that is related to kids audience and you don't update it, you don't update it right, you might have problem with YouTube. And according to the American law, they say you might have up to $4,000 fine if you upload the content that is made for kids and you put it no, it's not made for kids. So the law is really, really serious. The advantage of the meant for kids is really not easy. The functions are quite challenging. Yes, they are. They are. Trust me. Trust me. And if you click on, if your channel has a lot of made for kids, they're going to turn off your story. Like if you have a story, they're going to turn it off. They're going to turn off community posts. They're going to turn off your comments. Like nobody can comment on any video that is made for kids. No, you will not have access to story. You will not have access to community posts. There's a lot of things that you will not have access to when your channel is made for kids. When you click your channel or your channel made for kids, they will turn off a lot of things, like a lot of things from your channel. So I would advise you, if you don't really want that to happen and you want to change content, I think it's best to just password private almost all the content that is related to Made for Kids and start making new content. If you don't want to remove all those functions on your channel, because you can't stay without having comments. Comments is really, really important when it comes to content creators, because that is how you get to interact with your audience. That is how you get to connect with your audience. So if your channel is Made for Kids, they're going to turn it off. If you have access to story, you will not have access to story anymore. Community post, where you can post as well, maybe post picture or post pool or post anything to ask your audience question, you will not have access to them anymore. So you know those things that makes you connect with your audience, you won't have access to them if your channels are made for kids. So they're really cutting off a lot of things for a channel that is made for kids, which I really feel for these people. When I read it, I was feeling bad somehow about it. You won't have it or no notification. Yes, exactly. I'm really feeling bad for most of these big channel that built their channel based on kids audience. I'm feeling bad for them. It's not easy, trust me. It's really, really, it's not easy at all. It's not easy. What if you have another channel for, if you have like me, I have a channel for my kids where I don't really post. What I post there is memory. I will say memory. Just when they are playing. I recently created the channel for Cosmo and Christina. I don't care about the viewers. I don't care about anything. I just, like, when I see something from, I just posted them. In the future, they will go back to that channel and see their memory there. So I have that. I just click that setting, Made for Kids. I know most of all these community assets because I already know what I'm putting myself into. So it's Made for Kids. I know they're going to, even in the future, they're going to turn off everything. But it's not a problem for me because it's not my main channel. It's channel for kids. You understand me? So if you have to, 13 years plus in America, I don't know how many years other country consider IG. So I'm just coming now. Oh, Nancy, you're coming now. I've explained a lot about this YouTube stuff. Well, if they will find us... Well, if they will find or join, you know, the comments is really important because at time, if someone have a question, how can they get exactly? So if it's Made for Kids, they don't want anybody to ask you any question. That you can't comment, even in your story, you can't express yourself. If you have up to 10,000 subscribers and you will have access to story, you won't have it anymore. On your community post, where people will comment. In fact, anything that will relate to comments, they will not give you access to anything. People can comment. So that is why it's important. Most of the content creators that can be able to, that has mostly Made for Kids content, I think it's best for them, if they don't want to start all over again, it's best to just take down most of their kids content. If 90% of the content they have on the channel is kid content, because it can't just stay without, you know, all these functions on YouTube that makes you connect with your audience. You can't just stay out. So if you don't want to lose your subscriber and start all over again, I think it's best you just take all those things down, the videos that will put you into that trouble down, and start creating another content. This is my, I know it's going to be hard, but I think this is my suggestion. I don't know about others. You won't blame YouTube when some communities are threatening to sue YouTube. So yes, you won't blame them, because a lot of people can really comment horribly on that people's video. Trust me. In fact, I know YouTube is trying to look at, because they are trying to sue YouTube. That is true. So YouTube is trying to protect their company as well, because if they sue them, they are the one that will lose money, not us. You know, this is their company. This is their job. They are working hard to keep their job, keep their company growing in a better way. So I won't blame them. Honestly, I'm not blaming them, because they are not happy doing this thing to people, because they know that people, a lot of families are going to lose a lot of money. So they are human beings like us. They are not happy doing it. But in the same way, they are trying to protect their own company. They are trying, because they built this company. This is a company. YouTube is a company, just like Instagram, Facebook, and the rest, or normal company that both, all every, each and every one of us dream to have or has already. So they want to work hard to keep their company. So they won't want anything to take their company down or want their company to keep losing money because of what people are doing in the platform. So I don't blame them at all. I don't blame them. Yes, I don't blame YouTube. Yeah, that's the best advice as it stands now. It's the best advice. Cause move away from the lot that though. It's best. It's like exactly. I don't blame them because they are also trying to protect the kids over. Yes, they are trying to protect the kids and they are also trying to protect their company because a lot of parents have threatened to sue them. And trust me, when they sue them, it's money. You have to pay with. They have to pay. It's money. So, customer, can you go away from here? Customer, can you go away from here? My God, customer, eh? So they are the one that will lose the money too. So I don't blame them at all. Hold on, guys. Let's protect the kids. These kids won't let me. Oh. Guys, sorry. My kids won't let me be alone. Even if their dad is around today, they just don't want to let me be alone. So for me, like for instance, if this is my company and a lot of people are threatening me every time to sue me about because of a particular kind of customer, I will try to maybe I will just take it out or I will just quit the customer. So one, I don't blame YouTube because YouTube are human beings like us. They are feeling pain as much as those families that is going this thing is going to affect. Everybody is going to feel the pain. YouTube is not they are not like they are not bad, like they are not as bad as we think. It's people that force them, their hands are tied. If they have anything, like if they have a way to make this not to happen, they will make it not to take place because they know that a lot of families are losing money. They're going to lose the opportunity they have. They know that families makes a living from this YouTube. So they are not happy doing this. But if government says do this or you just close, they close down your company, you have to follow the rules, you know? So that is it, my dear. Change their creators and make for over. It doesn't matter. The changes. You don't even have to do that. If they change it and that is targeted for kids, trust me, YouTube is going to find that. So there's nothing like changing as long as you're making kids content. But your content is for kids. Whenever you change it from 18 years, they will find you, and it's not going to be good. So it's better not to make if you don't want if you're not in making like in the line of making content for kids. Don't just make it to change the date of your viewers. They know your audience. They know your audience if they are kids or not. So whether you change to 18 or you don't change to 18, it does not matter because YouTube already know your audience. They know people that click on that video. So that just do. Yes, I think it can be considered because they said here, let me see, I'm trying to see if I can go back to that email. They said if the model is kids, it can be considered as I won't change the way. You need to read, just take your time because the email is really long. You need to take your time to check the email. So I think because it's for kids, the hairstyle is for. I know that the hairstyle we're not getting. It's the mothers that wash it, but it's meant for kids, something for kids. It's just like you teaching, trying to teach your child how to read and write and everything. I know sometimes most parents sit down to learn, but the main people that need that content is targeted to are for kids. So yeah, I think even making child's hair is considered as I'm still I still need to we still need to wait for this reply from YouTube, but I think it's considered as a kid's content as well. Instead of putting it on private, put it on meant for kids. Yeah, you can put it on meant for kids for them to just turn off that part. Goggles are up. I don't know what that person is saying. God thank God's love. Yeah, just if as long as all your videos, Cindy, is not kids con like kids made for kids. Anyone that you know that is made for kids, just put it on made for kids. Just put that particular one on made for kids and leave your channel the way it is, because your channel, you create different things on your channel, so your channel is not made for. But if you are family vlogger, I think it's best you show less of your kids, for me, because this is why I want to start showing less of my kids. Honestly, the email is really long. If you are patient, you won't have time to read it. Just grab your coffee and read the email. I'm telling you, when they send it, I had to sit down and read. But if you go to that YouTube page, YouTube channel, you Creators Studio here on YouTube, the video explain most of that. The video, you need to watch the video. It explain a lot of that, a lot of the updates. It will give you more insight, like more light to the updates. So this is why I said you people should go to their channel, YouTube Creators channel. Here, this is the channel. This is their channel here. They have the latest updates, like here. When you go to YouTube Creators channel, this video explains everything. This video here, click it and take your time to watch it. It's just 6 minutes, 44 second video. It explains a lot of that email. You will understand it very well. So if you can't just go to their channel to watch that video, you will understand. Whoa. If so, I need to change those videos to made for kids. I think so. I think those videos are made for kids. I think so, honestly, because even my own videos where my son was eating, I had to put that video on private. I didn't want to leave the video up at all. So it's just my choice. I still have the opportunity to put it for made for kids, but I just take it out, put it on private. In the future, I might be deleting it as well. So a lot of things, we just need to like put less of our kids if you don't want your channel to consider, because if you have a lot of videos made for kids, your channel might not, your channel, I know a lot of people are having a viewers problem right now. Your channel might end up having more, you know, because when they find out that you have a lot of videos that is made for kids, they might consider not promoting. We already have problem for viewers right now, so they might, you might be having even less viewers because of that. So I consider you should put less, like your kids less, or you can just create a channel where you showcase your kids hairstyle or every other thing your children are doing. People will still go there to watch. So because most of this video you put meant for kids are not going to be monetized, and even if they're monetized, you won't be getting any serious stuff. So if you just want to, for me, if you just create a separate channel for your kids and do everything for your kids there, and just have your own channel where you do your stuff, you know, to just put away the worry of you don't know how this one is going to be on, how that one, just make it for your kids and for your kids alone. People will still go there to watch it. Just keep uploading for your kids in that channel. You know that one is meant for kids, so in the future, whatever that happens, you know, you just create that one just for the kids and not having a lot of can I see I'm in Italy, please. Nancy, what part of Italy are you? So just for me, creating a kids channel is the best thing to do, you know. Just create it and upload only kids stuff there. Take them out of your main, even if you want to put your children in your main channel, just put them once in a while to avoid it, because when you have a lot of video meant for kids, I think they will consider your channel not just meant for kids, and they will stop promoting most of your videos, because if they find out that you have a lot, like tons of videos meant for kids, they might not really take your channel that serious, because a lot of updates are coming out, and nobody will be happy to after you work, or like after you sit down and this video, do everything, and you end up we already not happy that we're not having viewers, and when you work hard and your revenue will be going down, or you might not get monetized, nobody will be happy to be working on that. So it's best to just have a channel separate for Made for Kids, and then just have your own channel doing your own stuff you're doing every day. My own suggestion, I'm not saying you should take it, I'm just suggesting, just like what I did, just put out my one channel for my kids where I just upload stuff for them, just things for them, anything they like, anything I feel to upload, maybe where they are playing or where they are doing one thing or the other, because my father-in-law normally go to watch the kids. There is just for the kids, it's just them doing their stuff, crying or shouting, dancing and the rest of it. So that is why I just put them in that channel, and they want to show them less here. So it's your choice to make, guys. So yeah, I shall vlogging without kids might be boring, honestly, because kids makes it fun. Yeah, that is why kids makes it fun, and you attract kids because of kids makes it fun. The kids attract other kids to watch it, because for instance, my son, sometimes when Cosmo is handling tablet, watching cartoon, before you know, he will start watching videos. There are adults inside, like maybe the father of the child or the mother of the child. They are just running around the background, and he will click on this this video. He's watching it, and he's a child. So you see what I'm saying? So as long as the child is, like, your child is one of the main character in that video, it's meant for kids, because kids click in such thing to watch. I've seen Cosmo a couple of times in I'm talking about YouTube Kids, because most of these channels are on YouTube Kids. Cosmo click on it. Sometimes I'll be like, what are you watching? Maybe people that is eating, a child and the father eating it's on YouTube, because I don't let him watch normal YouTube. I sign up for YouTube Kids. So all those things, they are on YouTube Kids, and kids, sometimes I don't find it funny. I don't let him watch such, because that is not his kind of video that he's supposed to be watching. If he's watching cartoon, he has to watch normal cartoon, not watching a father or a mother and a child that is eating always. They enjoy that kind of videos. So as long as the child is the character of that, even if the adult is there, it's considered made for kids. So this is why I'm saying, if you are creating any content that your child is going to be in the front, kids are definitely going to click on that video. So it's meant for kids for me, because I sometimes find it offensive when Cosmo is watching most of it in a YouTube Kids. So it's best you put less of your kids and just do your thing. Create your content and just create it for yourself and for your audience, which is adult, and try to let your kids out of most of your content to avoid all this made for kids stuff, because maybe you don't consider it made for kids, but YouTube will consider it made for kids, and they will go reset it for you. Yes, trust me, you are right. Even my kids does that. So that is it, my dear. Is most of that, we adults, we don't consider it made for, but kids actually end up watching that kind of videos. So you see, I think it's best to put less of kids, because YouTube can change. It's best to put less of kids, and if you love putting your kids, or you love your audience to watch your kids, sometimes it can just create their own space. Like, just create a channel for them where you post them. Anyone that wants to watch them, anyone that loves to watch, they can go there to see your kids. But do your own thing, be your own boss for your own company. Let's say this YouTube channel is a company, just be your own stuff, do your own stuff as an adult, create some things for the adults, just for adults to watch, to protect your channel, because nobody would like to work at the end of the day, you see nothing, or maybe because of too much of that, you'll be putting one thing or the other. So Cindy, thank you for joining me. Cindy, thank you so much. I think it's best. Okay, sis, thanks for the chat and more navigation. Let me run. Thank you. Thank you, Ghost. I'm no problem. I'm rounding up also too, because I need to go attend to Christina. I thank you guys for joining me here. Thank you so much. I really enjoyed having chat with you guys. Thank you guys. Love you guys. Ciao. Bye, everyone. Bye.